Hello everyone, it's Jess Hartz, and today we're building a witch's cabin and caravan. This was super fun to build. I saw the Realm of Magic trailer, and I absolutely flipped sticks, as people probably assumed I would. So I had to build something, and as if none of you already know, but the pack is coming out on the 10th of September, and it seems like they were super keen to get the mosquito pack out of the way. Heck, I feel like it was only a few days ago I was building a house based on the arrival of that pack. Oh well, the more the merrier, I guess. I am super excited. If you're new, I am crazy for the spooky and mystical. So this is right up my alley. I've always loved witches, from Harry Potter to the Witches of Eastwick to the Left 4 Dead series. Safe to say, I love my witches. I know a lot of people aren't into like supernatural things, and that's fine. You can appreciate this build despite it. I was half tempted to make the bedroom inside the Gypsy's caravan, but then I thought it wouldn't really make sense, so I thought, yeah, I'll turn that into the main conjuring spell work room. I really love the interior of these builds though. These kinds of builds make me super happy because I can just go over the top with the clutter, and no matter how weird it looks at the beginning, the more you add, the better it looks. I also love making that little pumpkin patch at the front. I totally live in this like cabin, to be honest, like with that garden and everything. I'm not quite sure if the pond is functional. I think you need to put like a little fishing sign in front of it. So if you know how to find them in the debug menu, you can turn that into a fishing pond. Which is always fun, and it's always good for skill building. Anyway, we're pretty much just decorating the exterior now. I'm putting on some like finishing touches of the house. And sorry if it's a little bit laggy and slow in some places, it's really annoying. I don't know what my game was doing that day. I think I had like too much stuff running on my second monitor, so it was like, don't play me, please, I'm dying. But yeah, you can see here I'm like starting on the little garden and like putting those pot plants on top of each other, or like planter pots, I don't know what they're called, and everyone's gonna make fun of me for saying pot plants. Yeah. Also, speaking of fishing, I haven't been in so heckin' long. I love fishing, and like, I know some of you might have issue with that, but don't stress, we did it as ethically as we could possibly do, and we never wasted any of our fish. But I won't lie, I was a gun at fishing. I remember we would go on my brother's boat with these kids, and it was so much fun. Oh, I loved it. Nostalgia. Have any of you been fishing? Unfortunately, my brother had to sell his boat, so that's probably why we haven't gone in a while, but I totally want to go with my boyfriend and his dad. On the other note of outside activities though, I love gardening, but I never mess with me mum's garden because she'd probably come at me with a pitchfork. And you might think that's an overestimation, but seriously, if I don't clean up my room, she comes at me with the broom. And yeah, actually, I was cleaning up portions of my room today and decluttering and stuff. I cleaned up my computer desk and it feels so nice and clean. I love some clutter, but like sometimes it feels like it's too much, if you get me. And when it's finished, I'd love to get some succulents and cacti. I love how they look so much. I was actually cleaning up like the art portion of my room and drawers, and I found all of my half-finished and finished paintings, and I had started a glass terrarium painting, and it looked pretty cool actually. And I want to keep painting, but I've been so busy, plus YouTube is like my main hobby, and nothing brings me quite the same amount of joy as finishing a video I'm proud of. But if I do some painting, would you guys like to see them and just some photos? I'd probably put them on Twitter anyway. I really should get back into it now that I think about it. But I suppose when you're busy, like, some of your passions do get put on the back burner, unfortunately. I'm hoping when I get my own place, I'd be able to do way more painting as well as decorating. Like, oh, that'd be a dream. Oh well, back to the build. We're finally on the interior of this build. And of course, I'm using a lot of debug objects. And yeah, I love decorating this place. I did also add on a bathroom because there was just not going to be enough room for what I wanted. And I guess it is still kind of a tiny home, but no, it really isn't a tiny home. It's like three rooms. Tiny homes barely have two rooms usually. Oh yeah, Twitter has spoken and people said I should start my witchy LP of the Realm of Magic before my initial non-witchy one. And I have to agree that I thought there would be a decent amount of time, like two-ish months before Realm of Magic came out, but it's only in a couple weeks. So it seems like we might be getting an expansion pack at the end of this year, considering we're getting so many so quickly. That's probably just me chin wagging, but I'm still excited for a witchy LP. What would you guys like to see? I'm tossing up a few ideas, but overly, I'd like to keep the main premise from you guys a secret. But I'm thinking about putting in some polls on Twitter, like cat or dog familiar, adult or teen, romance, no romance, so we can build a sort of story together. I think that would be really fun and good for you guys to choose what you want to see. Either way, I'm super excited. I wonder how many times I've said excited so far. Oh, damn. I'm just praying that the gameplay is good in this new pack and not shallow in any kind of way. I know some folks be a bit peed off where you can only build in one lot in the magical realm, but you know, we got two worlds, so I'm gonna let that one happily slide. I'm mostly keen to see the new normal world. From the looks of it, it kind of looks like an old foresty town, maybe a bit old Americana. Maybe that's just because I've seen too many witch and vampire shows that take place in old Americana towns. I do have a heap of ideas for builds though, so I'm pretty keen. I think one of the gurus was like cheekily avoiding answering this question if there were like new stairs, and someone said, ooh, maybe there's spiral stairs, and that's why they're avoiding the question. Like, they'd probably just answer that if they were normal stairs, now that I think about it. Either that or they're just being a really, really rude tease, so I don't know. I don't think there will be though, because I'm skeptical, but it would be a great pack for it. And as a funny note, when I was little, I thought warlocks were some form of like ogre or orc, like not a wizard. I had no like visual reference for what an orc was. I don't even know. I think I watched the movie Bewitched and she said warlock, and that's when I first heard the term, and I was like, what's that? I know, that's pretty odd. Yeah, I had to switch around a couple things in like the main living room and the bedroom, because like I just realized that there would not be enough room for a desk in the bedroom, but I gave this person like a hell of a lot of things to do. So there's a lot of gardening, easels, a violin. Yeah, I think that's about it. That's, I guess, a lot. I don't know. I don't play The Sims enough, so I don't know what's, like, the right amount of things to do. Usually in my builds, I try to think, like, if there's a heap of kids' bedrooms, I'll give one a violin, or I'll give one the drawing table thingy that's overused to heck. Yeah. Oh yeah, guys, remember to join in on my new build challenge. It's until the 3rd of September. It's a tiny house challenge. The shell is up on the gallery. Just search hashtag JessHartsTinyChallenge, read the rules, and upload your version with the same hashtag. You can add a story to the description if you like. I promise I read them all, and hopefully there isn't too many entries so I can feasibly put a montage at the end of the video. I do love doing tours so much. It's so much fun, like, plus seeing all like the little funny and cheeky parts that kind of break the fourth wall. I love that. It's super creative. I feel like I almost have to make the next challenge with a realm of magic in mind, but I won't make it like mandatory to have it in your build because not everyone's gonna buy it. Should we do a fantasy themed build challenge? I think we should. Speaking of that though, I've been half tempted to build Shrek Swamp again. I did like a year ago and it looks bad, I think. It made me so nostalgic though, and we all know how much I love making theme builds. Oh my gosh, so actually the house that I'm building right now is inspired by a game. It's a building for next week's video. It's massive and it's so filled with clutter. I am so excited. It's one of my favorite games of all time. I believe Deligracy somewhat played it. It's a story-based game, so you can't go against like what's laid out for you. You just have to play out the interactions and what happens. It's so amazing and definitely something I suggest you go and or play when you see the title of my video, because I will most definitely be giving spoilers and my own interpretation of the game, because it's very easy to have different interpretations of what the game actually means. It's gonna be pretty hectic, so yeah. What's your favorite kind of games, actually? What's some of your like childhood games? Like, it could be anything. Despite The Sims, of course, but I did build this house last year at some point, but boy, it looks terrible. I just wanted to make it as accurate as possible because this game deserves that. And this house has 7 levels, and I'm talking in this game, The Sims, 7, and none of them are basement levels. This indeed spun my head around when building that house, but that's not all. There's also 2 basement levels, I believe. It's so intense as heck, and I'm struggling whether or not to like put it in two parts, so I suggest you all stick around for that. Okay, so pretty much we're decorating, or we were just decorating, the interior of the gypsy caravan. I don't know if I should use that term because I don't want people to think it's derogatory in nature. I just know like that stereotypical gypsy caravan kind of vibe, or like a witchy caravan. But yeah, made that and all like that spell casting area with the cauldron. I have so much fun laying down levels and levels of clutter. Ah, love it. But yeah, we're pretty much at the end of the build now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I really, really hope you enjoyed this build. I put it on a 20 by 30 lot in Granite Falls. Is it granite or granite? Because I think that's how you spell granite, like the mineral. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Also, there's a funny story from last night before I forget, while we're in the screenshots. I was outside and I heard something underneath the deck, so I started stomping on the deck to try and scare it away because it was scaring me. And then I like ran inside and my neighbor was in the window, this old fella, and he was just like staring. And I'm like, oh my god, he saw me dancing around like a blue-ass fly. Oh, that's so embarrassing. So yeah, we'll end on a little funny story for you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, but I gotta go. So remember to subscribe, like and comment, tick that bell, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!